Thank you, Jesus. You're going to be live in the next 9 minutes. Hallelujah. It's Sister Betty here, Revival Sister Betty. And I thank you so much for being here. Today is Wednesday. And the Lord has a word for us. So just join in. And I know we will receive the blessings of the Lord. Welcome so much. We were here on Monday. Today is on Wednesday. Wednesday is Prayer Monday. And on Monday we have Prayer Monday. And on Wednesday we have time for the Word of God. Because the Word is the bread of life. It is what makes us to live. Like Jesus said, we shall not live on bread alone. Hallelujah. So welcome so much. Welcome so much. I'm waiting for you to come in online so that we can share the Word of God and so that you can be blessed, so that I can be used as an honorable vessel in the name of Jesus Christ. So let us just be listening to this song here, and I know it is going to bless your soul in the name of Jesus Christ. By Chris Tomlin, Lord, I need you. Hallelujah. Please come lead, Lord, I need you. It's time for what? This Wednesday, we have 5 minutes before we begin. So just keep on sharing. Sharing is caring with everybody so that we can get a chance to eat from the Lord's table in the name of Jesus. Welcome, welcome.
Thank you.
Yes. Oh God, how I need you. By Chris Tomlin. Hallelujah. Welcome to today's service. And I thank the Lord because of giving us another opportunity to meet. It is by His grace. It is by His mercies. It is by His love we can get to meet once again. We were here on Monday this week for prayers. And today is on Wednesday. We are equally going to meet because of the word of God. That is why you're here. And today is going to be about the word. And I thank God because the Lord has a message for you. He also has a message for me. Meanwhile, keep on sharing, because He says sharing is caring. Because, you know, once you share, there's somebody who needs to hear this, but they cannot get to hear it if you've not shared it. So you can also say, Sister Betty is online, the Revival Sister Betty is online. You can share with your friends on your Facebook page, whichever platform the Lord is going to lead you to share, because of His word, because of His glory, because of His power, not mine, but let Him take all the glory in the name of Jesus Christ. So welcome so much. I am honored to have you here. And I know every time we meet, the Lord has something. And we are meeting here because the Lord has put something in my spirit to share with you. And I know that once the word comes, you shall eat of it. And later on, you'll be able to at least have time to meditate so that you can see what the Lord was trying to tell you, so that you can either change, so that you can share with other people, fellow brethren, also non-believers, and I know that you will be blessed. So welcome so much. You just had the song from Chris Tomlin, Lord, I Need You, and just have an expectant heart, because every time the Lord brings in a word, it's not a normal word. It should not be a normal word. It should be something that should make you to go to another level. It should cleanse your spirit. It should cleanse your mind. It should be able to do something in your spirit in the name of Jesus Christ. So welcome very much. Welcome very much. Welcome so much. Welcome so much. I am so excited. I am so excited to deliver what the Lord wants us to deliver today in the name of Jesus Christ. So thank you for those who of us who I am alive on Facebook. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. And you want to begin our service. So just be ready to hear from the Lord. And I know that the Lord is going to bless us. But above everything, I am saved. I love the Lord as me. So let us just pray and begin another prayer. And I know the Lord is going to help us. So you can just bow your head down. It's always good to begin with a word of prayer, so that the Lord can do what He wants to do today. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I worship You. I thank You for this time that You have honored Your servant with. I thank You for Your anointing. I thank You for Your power. I'm about to deliver Your word to Your people. Whoever is going to listen to this, whoever is going to watch this alone, I declare, Holy Spirit, may You convict them in the name of Jesus Christ. To the honor and glory of Your name, O Lord. I thank You because this is a platform for us to share the word of God, not to entertain anyone, O Lord, but so that Your children can change their way, so that they can know it is You speaking to their spirits in the name of Jesus. As You continue, I declare Your power, I declare Your glory, I declare Your anointing, and that this servicing of Your glory shall continue in the name of Jesus Christ. I declare in the spirit that there shall be no other power here apart from the power of the Holy Spirit. I worship You, I thank You in the name of Jesus. You believe and pray. Amen. Thanks for watching. Thanks for logging in. Our Lord is faithful. And I'm so glad to see you here. I am so blessed to see you here so that we can continue in the word of the Lord. So God bless you so much. And like I started, I say, just keep on sharing so that this message can go to the whole world, because I believe it can go to the whole world. And those people that the Lord has purposed to listen to it or to watch it, those are the people who are going to watch it in the name of Jesus Christ. So thank you so much for getting in live. Our time is so good. We want to begin on time and finish on time. And we'll be blessed. We've already prayed. And today is on the 1st of December. And because you've seen this new month, you really need to thank God. It's amazing. There's somebody who didn't get to see this month. There's somebody who died yesterday. And there was somebody who was also born today. But the fact that you have seen this new month, I'm telling you, it's the grace of God. And when we, as we are drawing closer to December 31st, the end of this year, we need to keep on praying as we anticipate the coming year, because I know the Lord is going to do it, and just be prepared for what the Lord is doing in His church. So we want to read the Word of God, want to share the Word of God. And the Word of this word for today is actually a seasonal one. And it's a word that is going to take you through the month of December. Hallelujah. This is the one that is going to take you through the word of to the month of December. And that is the one that the Lord has given you. A word to take you through the season of December. Is the Lord amazing? So you're not here in vain, but you're here to listen to what does God want me to do in the month of December. What do I need? How do I need to prepare? What is there for me? In the name of Jesus Christ. So you can just open your Bible. But before you open your Bible, our heading for today is, you know, we're in a festive season. And a festive season is a time whereby we get to take some time out. The Lord gives us some time out. During the year, I know you've worked very hard, whether you are in the ministry or you're working, you're a banker, you're a teacher, whatever profession that you have. We know that when it comes to the month of December, it's a month for us to take some time off, at least to relax our minds, relax our bodies, and at least with our families. So it is acceptable. So I want to talk about a certain spirit that comes at the end of the year. And I think we've all seen it. We all know it. And since you're here, I know that God is going to help you so that you don't get to that place. So our title for today on What Toast Wednesday is the spirit of being lukewarm, yeah, in the festive season. So when we say somebody's being lukewarm, is that you're neither hot or you're neither cold, or at some point you are hot, and as time went, you became cold. Remember, when we reach the festive season, most of people are on relaxing mode. Whether you're a believer or an unbeliever, it's a time for us to maybe to wind up, to relax. We get to not to work hard so much. It's the time that maybe we have been given by our God, because that is a time that the Lord wants us to do something. So we want to talk about the spirit of being lukewarm, especially at a season like this, at a time like this. So anyone who's going to listen to this word, I want you to pay keen attention. I want you to be very attentive, and I want you to listen to what the Holy Spirit is saying to the church. And I know by the time you're going through these weeks, you'll be able to listen to this video, watch it again and again, so that you do not fall into some of the things that the enemy does to believers in the name of Jesus Christ. So we are talking about the spirit of being lukewarm, and it is something that is there. It is in our churches. And I want us to read from the book of Revelation chapter 3, verses 15 and 16. And you're going to see what the Lord thinks about somebody who's lukewarm. What does the Lord feel about somebody who's lukewarm? Like we said, a lukewarm person is somebody who's neither hot or cold. You know, we're just in the middle. So we don't know whether you're hot or you are cold. In the name of Jesus Christ, open your Bible in the book of Revelation chapter 3. Revelation is the last book of the Bible. I thank you, Lord. Rimazika mabo shandara babosika. I thank you. Revelation chapter 3 from verses 15 to 16 says this. I want you to see what the Lord thinks about those people who are lukewarm, and you will be amazed. It is something that is not so good. I know you read this verse before, but there's a new revelation. So Revelation chapter 3 verses 15 to 16 says this. I will read in the name of Jesus, King James Version. I know thy works, that thou, because thou art lukewarm and neither cold nor hot, I will spit thee out of thy mouth. In the name of Jesus Christ, I'm declaring that this network shall submit to the power of the Holy Spirit and to the anointing upon his servant. Let me read that again. Revelation chapter 3 verses 15 to 16. Yeah. I know thy works, that thou art neither cold nor hot. I will thou art cold or hot. 16. So then, because thou art lukewarm and neither cold nor hot, I will spill thee out of thy mouth. So those are the sentiments of the Lord. That is the word of the Lord. And clearly, the Lord doesn't like people who are lukewarm. Because if you're lukewarm, it means you have no standing. You are just there. You are not hot. You are not cold. You are in the middle, in the name of Jesus Christ. So today we are talking about the spirit of being lukewarm in our churches, especially in this month of December, where most of us really want to enjoy ourselves because we believe we have worked so hard and we are entitled to that. That is not a bad thing. But question is, while you are enjoying yourself in this last month of the year, what are you doing? Are you going to move away from the Lord, or are you going to move closer to the Lord, knowing that there is a new year waiting for you? In the name of Jesus Christ, the times of the church sinning at this season and then repenting in the new year is over. And I want you to, and this word is my word, because the Lord is ministering to my spirit, but is also ministering to you. And what is Jesus saying to you today, this afternoon, in the name of Jesus? Just keep on sharing from the book of Revelation chapter 3, from verses 15 to 16. We are talking about this person who is Lakozika Mayanda Rabosaya Rababo Shaka Labozika. And I want to intercede, because I see the enemy doesn't want this word to go, but it will go in the name of Jesus. Shakata Rababo Zikayanda Ramabo Shekete Ribabo Zikayanda Ramo Zikenda Rababosika. You know, the Lord wants to help you today. And because He wants to help you, I'm praying in the name of Jesus that this word is going to go through. You're not going to have any challenges with the internet. So, welcome. We are proceeding and we are reading from the book of Revelation chapter 3, verses 15 to 16, about this lukewarm person. And we're in the month of December. Today is on the 1st. And I thank God you've seen it. I've seen it. But we are walking strong. We are finishing strong, because there are other days ahead of us. Hallelujah. Before Jesus Christ comes, He wants to get us. He says in His word, when I come back, will I find faith? In the name of Jesus Christ. So we just read from the book of Revelation chapter 3, from verses 15 to 16. And the Lord has talked about somebody's lukewarm. And the Lord is not too happy. You know, when you're lukewarm, the Lord says, it's His word, it's not mine, that He shall spew you from His mouth. In the name of Jesus Christ. I don't know if you've ever eaten something that is bitter and it does not go through your throat. You spew it out because you don't want to take it in, because you feel like this thing is too bitter. It's the same thing when you are lukewarm. And I'm praying in the name of Jesus Christ, because this is a word for December. It's a seasonal word. And the Lord is just trying to make sure that we are on our toes. We're not going to be those people who are going to be driven away by the enjoyment like the people of the world. In the name of Jesus Christ, it is not your portion. Hallelujah. So we have this fact. Most of the believers that I know have backslidden in the month of December. That is a fact. Why? Because when we reach at this seasonal month, or at the time of December, a time where we get to rest, the festive season, most of the times we take some time off. You might not be in church as you go to church. Sometimes we want to travel. You've decided to go maybe outside the country. You're going to Mombasa. You're going to see every other relative in town. You're going to do other things. But the thing is, during the year, we have had our time with God. But when it comes to December, this month that the Lord has given us, and I thank Him for that, what do you do? Most of the believers have backslidden in the month of December, because maybe they were enjoying themselves. They went in the wrong place. They forgot the work of the cross. They stopped praying. They stopped reading the word, and they went into a comfort zone in the name of Jesus Christ. But that is not what the Lord wants us to do. Remember, there are still days ahead of us. You don't have to enjoy yourself to the point of you lose yourself and you've forgotten you're saved. And then you want to come to church in January, kneel down before God every year and tell God, I'm sorry, I backslid. This is not the time, my friend, my brother, my sister, in the name of Jesus Christ. So what happens in that month if you lose your life, and maybe you went somewhere, you're in the wrong place, but because you had gone to enjoy yourself with other people, and then you leave this earth, what will be the conclusion of the matter? You'll go straight to hell in the name of Jesus. But I want to believe God, because you're here. Let us keep on sharing. We are walking in the month of December with power. We are not going to become lukewarm in the name of Jesus Christ. We are not going to forget our Lord Jesus, because we are in this month where everybody wants to rest. By the way, there's nothing like relaxing when it comes to in spiritual matters. It does not exist. There is nothing like a comfort zone when you are in the spirit. It is not there. Remember, we are being told in the word of God, we do not need to be ignorant of the enemy's schemes in the name of Jesus Christ. Can you keep on sharing? For those who have logged in, welcome. This is a seasonal message and it's going to help you. We've read from the book of Revelation chapter 3, from verses 15 to 16, and you're talking about the spirit of being lukewarm, especially in this month, in the name of Jesus Christ. So, let us not compromise. This word is for you. This word is for me, and the Lord wants to help somebody. And because you are listening to the voice of the Holy Spirit, I want to believe the Lord that in these coming weeks that we are going to have before we transition into the year that is coming, that is if the Lord is not going to come for his church, because we are being told to stay awake every time in the word of God, that you are going to meditate on the word that you're going to listen to today. In the name of Jesus Christ. So I want us to read from the book of Matthew chapter 24 from verses 37 to 42. Just take your Bible and open the book of Matthew chapter 24. Matthew is the first book of the New Testament. In the name of Jesus, I'm going to read it. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Welcome. For those who are coming in live, welcome. It's the Holy Spirit that has directed you. Matthew chapter 24. I just love the word of God. I love it. I love it. Marabo Shakarabo Zanda. I love the word of God. Matthew chapter 24. From verses 37 to 42. I want you to be very keen on this. I'm reading from King James in the name of Jesus. It says, "But as the days of Noah were, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be." Hallelujah. I hope you are together. Verses 38. "For as in the days that were before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, until the day that Noah entered into the ark." 39. "And knew not until the flood came and took them all away, so shall also the Son of Man be." I think you know all the story of Noah, our first evangelist. He used to preach to the people and telling them that Christ is coming back soon, like we are doing today. We are telling people, Christ is coming back soon. Stop what you're doing. Stop sinning. The Lord is here. He's speaking to you. And preaching the message of the cross everywhere. But you know, people are just being ignorant for their own reasons. But there's a point here. When Noah was preaching, they were busy doing other things in the name of Jesus Christ. So I'm imagining they were having fun doing all of these things. But the flood came. And the time that the flood came and it rained, everybody was swept away. Back to my point. We are in this month of December in the name of Jesus Christ. Like I said, the Lord expects us to keep watch in prayer, to keep watch as we read the word of God. Let us not be like the people who are being preached to at the time of Noah. They were busy enjoying themselves. I'm imagining maybe it was in December. I don't know. That is just me saying. The time that everybody is concentrating on, oh my goodness, I've been saving the whole year. I need new shoes. I need new clothes. I want a new TV. I want to do every other thing that I'm doing. But the question is, while you are doing all of these other things, are you preparing for that storm? Who's to say if Christ is going to come tomorrow? Because you're still waiting for him. In the name of Jesus Christ. And nobody knows the day. Nobody knows the hour. But the Holy Spirit, the spirit of truth that is in us, expects us to keep the fire burning. In the name of Jesus Christ. So at the time of Noah, as we are being warned, you know, this is a warning. And I love warnings, because when you're being warned, when you're being warned, it means Christ loves you. So he's warning you in advance and telling you, you need to look at this, you need to read this, you need to follow this, you need to prepare for this, for what is coming in the name of Jesus Christ. So while these people are busy celebrating and doing every other thing like everybody is going to do in the month of December, something is going to happen in the name of Jesus Christ. And we cannot ignore this. Hallelujah. There's nothing wrong with the festive season, but don't overdo it. Don't forget who you are. Don't forget you've been filled by the Holy Spirit. Don't forget you're being separated because of the work of God. There are things that we are not going to do, even if you're going to be in our houses, even if you're going to travel. But the Lord doesn't expect you to go everywhere. He doesn't expect you to eat everything. He doesn't expect you to behave like somebody who has not, who did not receive Jesus Christ. And then come next year, we want to see over 1,000 souls coming to Christ. No. No. In the name of Jesus Christ, no. That is a time for you to share the word of God. That is a time for you to draw closer to God. That is a time for you to go into deep prayers and fasting so that the Lord can speak to you, so that you can receive a divine revelation for what is to come. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are not amongst those people who are changed by certain situations. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the living God. I thank you, Jesus. I worship you. One of the things that happened in the festive season is that people spend a lot of money. Amen. We spend a lot of money on things that are not relevant, on money, on friends, and we run into debt. Hallelujah. We are still in the scripture. In the name of Jesus Christ, there are still days that are coming. In the name of Jesus Christ, this is a time that people, you want to spend a lot. This is a time whereby is a period where many accidents happen on the road. I think these are things that we know. Because the enemy is at work. Most people actually lose their lives in this month. In the name of Jesus Christ, many sacrifices are also done in this month. So how can you sleep at a time like this? We are not supposed to sleep. We are supposed to keep awake and keep on praying in the name of Jesus Christ. This is a time where people are busy doing so many things. But because you're here today and you're talking about this spirit of being lukewarm, because I'm believing this is somebody who was maybe hot, but because we are nearing to the end, they've reached a place whereby they have compromised. They've reached a place where there is laxity. They have relaxed in the name of Jesus Christ. Praise the name of the living God. The Lord wants to help you today. The Lord wants you to keep on preparing. Even if you're going to go for that festive period in this month, you have to prepare. You have to remember that Jesus loves you, and you have to be very, very careful in the name of Jesus Christ. I was doing some Bible study today, and the Lord is very faithful. The Lord is very faithful. Galatians chapter 6 verse 7 says that God cannot be mocked. God cannot be mocked in the name of Jesus Christ. You see, the same fire that you have for those who are on fire, because not everybody is on fire, can you keep that fire burning? Can you keep that fire burning in the name of Jesus Christ? I want us to look at, how do we deal with this spirit? How do you make sure that this spirit does not get to you in the name of Jesus Christ? Like I said, this is a word for the whole of December, and it is a seasonal one. So after this, you'll go through it, and I know that the Lord is going to help you. How do we fight this spirit and make sure that we do not behave the same way that non-believers behave, and may the Lord help them in the name of Jesus Christ? Point number one, what do you need to do? Do not relax when it comes to spiritual disciplines. That is our point number one. Do not relax when it comes to spiritual disciplines in the name of Jesus Christ. The same way that you've been praying, if you've been praying for 1 hour, go for 2 hours. If you've been praying for 2 hours, go for three. If you've been praying for three, go for 4 hours in the name of Jesus Christ. Do not relax. Do not put your belt down. Mababo shata rabaza rekamabosika. Do not put your belt down. In the name of Jesus Christ, do not relax. Don't relax. Don't relax. Don't relax. In the name of Jesus Christ. And don't change your routine in the name of Jesus Christ. You've been going for morning glory. God bless you. Even if you're not going to go for morning glory, when that hour comes, wake up and pray in the morning. The Lord is still there. Hallelujah. We do not expect our pastors to follow us everywhere to ask us, what are you doing? They don't have that time in the name of Jesus Christ. But because you have been saved and you know what you're supposed to do and you have been called alone, not with your mother, not with your brother, not with your sister, you need to know that we cannot relax. That is point number one. Do not relax in the name of Jesus Christ. Keep your routine going. Don't let anybody influence you and tell you, no, it's five. Lord, I've been praying the whole year. Yes, you've been praying the whole year. So don't stop praying the whole year. Keep on praying the whole year. In the name of, even in the month of December, in the name of Jesus Christ. And one of the things you want to say when you're saying you're not relaxed in spiritual discipline is in prayers, like I've said. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 17 says, pray without ceasing. Hallelujah. Pray without ceasing. You are praying everywhere like a madman. In the vehicle, you are praying. In your bed, in your praying, in your spirit. But don't pray when you're in your bed. You stand up and pray in the name of Jesus Christ. Whatever it is that you're going, you're praying. Like I said, this is the final hour. This is the final hour. Don't wait for anything else. And Christ is coming so soon. And those who are in the spirit, I think you already know what the storm that is coming. But when it comes to you, it should not be a storm. It should not be a surprise, because you're already prepared. And you know that he's just in the air waiting for God to command his angels to blow the trumpet. And soon we are going home in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm hearing an amen in the spirit. There's somebody saying amen. So, when you're talking about prayers and you said not, do not relax, prayers go together with fasting. I know it's December. I know it is December. But that is not to say you're going to go a whole month without prayers and then you're going to tell God, this is January. Let me just eat the D. Let me just eat the D. When we go to the month of in January, you're going to pray for 1 month. No, you're going to be down. The enemy is going to put you down because you're going to start operating in the flesh. In the name of Jesus Christ, remember, you're not praying and you're not fasting. You are not in the spirit. You are going to start operating in the flesh in the name of Jesus Christ. But because we are listening to this sermon, I know that God is going to help us in the name of Jesus Christ. Don't be afraid. This word is yours. This word is mine. Something else, a very important spiritual discipline is reading the word of God. Because if you're praying and fasting, you also need to read the word of God. God says in the book of Colossians that, let the word of the Lord dwell in you richly. Hallelujah. So meaning that even if you're not going to be in your church, or you are going to be in your house, wherever it is that you're going to be, you need to read the word of God so that the Lord can also speak to you, so that he can also talk to you in the name of Jesus Christ. So that is from the book of Colossians chapter 3, verse 16. Those are very important spiritual disciplines. Like I said, you cannot relax in prayer. You cannot relax in reading the word of God in the name of Jesus Christ. I want us to go to point number two. Keep on sharing. This message is very important. It is very important. Keep on sharing. I've been studying and meditating on this word, and it's also for me in the name of Jesus Christ. Point number two, avoid making decisions without consulting the Holy Spirit. I'm interceding in the name of Jesus. It is well. It is well. Point number two, we've said that avoid making decisions without consulting the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is the Spirit of truth. You know, at a time like this, there are so many things that are going on. There are so many things that are happening. And remember, maybe you're not in church, but you will have to make decisions. Yeah, you'll have to make decisions. But before you make any decision, before you go anywhere, hallelujah, before you walk with anybody, before you do anything at this time, can you consult the Holy Spirit? Can you consult the Holy Spirit? How many people have made one wrong choice and have regretted for their lives for like a lifetime? Don't do anything without consulting the Holy Spirit. Don't just listen to what people are talking about, because the Holy Spirit of truth is in you. Can you consult that inner man before you do anything? In the name of Jesus Christ. Because that is an avenue that the enemy is using to make sure that you do not walk in the right path. Like some of these family gatherings, and I'm not saying they are bad, but can you consult the Lord? If they're going to be taking alcohol and you're there and you're saying you are just there, already you are defiled. In the name of Jesus Christ, there are some things that they do there that are not godly, and you are there. Consult the Lord. The Lord will speak to you in the name of Jesus Christ, because he's faithful, and we are going to heaven. We do not want to do things that are going to draw us away from the Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ, before you go for any meeting, can you consult the Holy Spirit first in the mighty name of Jesus Christ? And the Lord is going to help us because he is good. If you do not give the Holy Spirit that chance to speak to you and to talk to you at a time like this, I want you to believe that you're going to make a decision that is not going to be of the Lord. And later on, you're going to say, Lord, why did you allow such a thing to happen to me? Even when you're going to take that matter too, can you even pray to the Lord? You are traveling. You have to pray. You have to ask the Lord, before I take this vehicle, can you just take control of this vehicle? I'm praying over this vehicle. I want to reach my destination. Those are the things that we are talking about. Don't just assume that you're being prayed for by the man of God. Don't assume things. Do not assume. You have the power. You have the authority to pray over things and to pray over matters. But if we do not consult the Holy Spirit, I am assuring you we are going to do our own things. Consult the Lord. There is that inner voice that speaks to us. You're going to hear maybe a yes or a no, or the Lord is going to draw you to reading a specific word. Praise the name of the living God. Even some of the things that we are watching, in the name of Jesus Christ, you never used to watch them, but now you're at home. You feel like you have nothing to do, in the name of Jesus Christ. But that should not be our portion, in the name of Jesus Christ. So can you just keep on sharing as you continue with the word of the Lord? I want us to read from the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 2, verses 11. We are still on point number 2, yeah? After this, we are going to really pray. We are going to pray. And the Lord is going to guide us. 2 Corinthians chapter 2, verses 11. We are reading this word because this word is very powerful. It is not my own word. It is straight from heaven's kitchen. Hallelujah. 2 Corinthians chapter 2, verses 11. Hallelujah, hallelujah, Jehovah. 2 Corinthians chapter 2, verses 11 says this, yeah? You're there, we can read. My Bible is King James Version. I love King James Version. It says this. Okay, 2 Corinthians chapter 2, verses 11 says that, lest Satan should get an advantage of us, for we are not ignorant of his devices. In the name of Jesus Christ. You know, ignorance is not an excuse before God. There's nothing like ignorance before our Lord Jesus Christ. The only thing is, you need to realize that this is a device of the enemy, and make conscious decisions that are going to please the Lord and are not going to please people. I want you to know one thing. If you make a decision that is going to please somebody, of course, you have decided to please somebody else and not please the Lord. And the Holy Spirit cannot dwell in a place whereby he has not been given an opportunity for consulting, in the name of Jesus Christ. I thank you, King of all glory. I want us to continue. And even as we continue, we shall just continue with the word that the Lord has given us, and we shall be blessed. I thank you, Holy Spirit. I want us to go to our point number 3. We are looking at the things that we need to deal with during this season, so that we do not fall victim to being lukewarm at a time like this. When Christ Jesus is coming for the church, he expects you to be hot. He expects you to be fiery, in the name of Jesus Christ. Point number 3. Look at those people who have surrounded you and the kind of influence that they are impacting in your spirit. I'm going to repeat that statement. Point number 3. Look at those people who are surrounding you, in the name of Jesus. and the kind of influence that is being implanted in your spirit. In the name of Jesus Christ. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 33. Keep on sharing, keep on sharing, keep on sharing, keep on sharing. Like we said, sharing is caring. We don't want anybody to fall victim at this season. In the name of Jesus. 1 Corinthians chapter 15. Yeah. 1 chapter 15. Verses 33. There is something that is there. Be not deceived. Evil communications corrupt good manners. Let us just be honest with ourselves here. If you're going to be walking around with people who are of the world, expect bad communication. They don't speak like us. They don't think like us. They don't do things the same way that we do. In the name of Jesus Christ. I'm not saying that you should not share the gospel with them. You can share with them. But there's something called boundaries. Boundaries, 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 boundaries. Who are you going to invite to your home at that time? Who are you going to be walking with? What are you surrounding yourself with? Because if somebody is defiling themselves with things of the world, they will also defile you. They will also defile you. You're not going to tell me that you're going to be somebody with somebody who is in the world and you're going to receive something good. That is a lie. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 33 confirms that. But if you're going to spend your time reading God's word, or maybe you have fellowship with a believer in the name of Jesus Christ, we are going to edify one another. But if you're going to tell me you're going to spend most of your time with people who don't even understand what heaven is, they don't even know what heaven is, they are not there, they don't want to get there, they don't know how to get there, and you fit to them, they're going to bring you down. They're going to bring you down because they're going to influence you in a wrong way. In the name of Jesus Christ, let me tell you, we are paying the price. And when it comes to paying the price, not everybody can be your friend. In the name of Jesus Christ, because you are purpose and you want to go to heaven. If you want to go to hell, that is fine. Everybody can, you can do what you want. Because for you to get to hell, the only thing you have to do is walk along that wide road. But if you're in the narrow path and you want to see Jesus Christ, there's something called self-sacrifice. Because your purpose in your mind, I want to see Jesus Christ. Your purpose in your heart, I'm going to do everything that it takes for me to see the Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ. The Lord is helping us this afternoon. And that is why you're on this platform. So that the Lord can help us to walk through this month of December in a powerful way, in a mighty. We don't want to have regrets later. Who's to say that when you're thinking of repenting, you'll still be here? What if you'll die without repenting? Don't do something with the mindset of, I know that my pastor is going to pray for me come next year. I am telling you, you'll be on the wide road and you're going somewhere that is very bad. In the name of Jesus Christ, let us do things the way the Lord wants us to do them and we shall be blessed. It's a high time people know that the times of walking in error and doing other things and then expecting that when the other year comes, you want to renew your salvation. Those times are far gone. Those times are far gone. Just walk in the path the Lord wants you to walk. Do not do things that are going to make you regret later on. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. I worship you. You are so good. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 33, like we've read. Be not deceived. Evil communications corrupt good manners. In the name of Jesus Christ. We are not amongst those that draw back. Hallelujah. You are a believer, but you want to run through those rallies and watch other things going. Let them do what they are doing. The Lord is going to help them. But you stand your ground and do what you're supposed to be doing at an hour like this. In the name of Jesus Christ. I am telling you, this is a tight race. The race is so tight. And the hour is at hand. And Christ is about to be revealed. And if he's going to be revealed at the month of December, and he's going to find us doing other things, I am telling you, the people of the world are going to laugh at us and are going to say, you would rather have taken alcohol. You would have rather done immorality. You would have rather done every other thing knowing you are going to hell. In the name of Jesus Christ. I want us to pay keen attention to what the Holy Spirit is saying. Because I am refusing this spirit of doing all of these things. Then come next year, we want to go on our knees. It does not work like that. God knows our motives. And if you sin willfully, like it is written in the book of Hebrews, judgment is waiting for you. Judgment is waiting for you. You will be judged. You will be judged in the name of Jesus Christ. You will be judged because you did it willfully, knowing that the Lord is so merciful. He's so gracious. God has two sides. There is mercy and there is judgment. And both are at work till today. In the name of Jesus Christ, I thank you. We are being warned in advance. We are being warned. We are all being warned. Don't go and do your own things, thinking that the Lord is not watching. He's watching. He's omniscient. He's omnipresent. He's watching what you're doing. In the name of Jesus Christ, can you stand your ground and decide which side you're on? Can you stand your ground? Can you stand your ground? Because very soon, the Lord is going to reward us all. He's going to reward us. Thanks for watching. We are continuing. Point number 4. Always remind yourself of Christ's coming. By being watchful, have a renewed mindset. Have a renewed mindset. A heavenly mindset. Knowing that, yes, I know we're in this month. I know so many things are going on, but I'm not looking at people. I'm looking at where I'm going in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. I'm looking at where I'm going. Philippians chapter 2, verses 5. Philippians chapter 2, verses 5. Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. You know, for you to achieve a mind of Christ, the mind that Christ had, in the name of Jesus Christ, we have to isolate ourselves from very many things. There's so much rubbish on TV. There's so many things that are going on. We have to isolate ourselves. For you to have that heavenly mind, you have to purpose in your heart to read the word of God, to pray, to listen to things that are godly, to watch things that are godly. Because whatever it is that is going to come in the eye, of course, is going to affect our mind. You know, there are so many things today on YouTube that are not helping anybody, but have over 50 million views, over 100 million views, and you're busy watching them. Get out of that. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. On Facebook. Those are platforms that can either be used to glorify God or can be used to finish you. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. You need to have a mind of Christ. But for you to achieve that, you cannot watch every other thing. It takes self-discipline. It takes self-sacrifice. Let me tell you. Sometimes we do our own studies. We are very innocent. And something else just comes up from nowhere. You had not even planned for it, and then you have to sanctify yourself. I'm telling you, it's so crazy. I'm telling you, this thing is very crazy. It is not easy as you think. It is very difficult, but you have to purpose in your heart. And that is why, even if you're going to go online, even if you're going to be doing something online, you have to be very careful. Some of these songs we listen to, it's like they look like they are godly, but there's another spirit that is inside. So if you don't pray, you're not going to have discernment. I'm talking up into heaven. Mababo Shantala Babosika. We are going to heaven. The Lord is here. I am telling you, the Lord is here. And this one is for you. This one is for me. Because I'm also asking the Lord to help me in the name of Jesus Christ. I don't want to behave like somebody who never knew Jesus Christ. I do not want to shame the Lord. I don't want to take him back to the cross because of 1 month that has 31 days. No, I don't want to do it. I want to make sure that I'm on fire for Jesus Christ. I want to make sure that when the Lord sees me, not men, He can actually say, "Welcome home, good and faithful servant. You are serving me. I acknowledge you. Your name is in the book of life. I'm not interested in any other thing." And that is why you are here, to listen to the word of God. Hallelujah. Do not get drifted away. We are now paying the price, but the Lord is going to reward us. So don't feel like you're going nowhere. No, don't be discouraged. Keep on praying. Keep on reading the word of God. Let your mind be filled with Jesus. Let your mind think of Jesus and where you're going. Don't focus on your problems. Don't do other things that are not going to give glory to our Father in heaven. Jesus loves you, and that is why you're listening to this sermon right now. A carnal mind will result in death, but a spiritual mind will result in life and peace. That is in the book of Romans chapter 8 verse 6. Don't allow carnality. Don't allow carnality. Don't allow carnality. In the name of Jesus Christ. I will read that for you to confirm that. Romans chapter 8 verse 6. I thank you, Lord. Romans 8, 6, yeah? It says this, huh? Let me begin from verse 5. For they that are after the flesh do mind the things of the flesh, but they that are after the Spirit, the things of the Spirit. Verse 6. For to be carnally minded is death. So if you don't have the mind of Christ, you have a carnal mind. You have a carnal mind. But to be spiritual minded is life and peace. Praise the name of the living God. That is Romans chapter 8 verse 6. We are at the end of the year. We are heading to the end of the year. Not everybody is going to see the end of this year. That is a fact. That is a fact. In fact, not everybody is going to go back home today. Just of life. But because the Lord loves you so much, and He pulled you out from darkness and brought you out to the light, and you have an opportunity like this, don't take it for granted. A time is going to come when you're not going to be able even to preach on I'm interceding. A time is going to come. We might not get platforms as this one to encourage us, to enlighten us. So this is a divine opportunity. A divine opportunity from the Lord Himself. We have been talking about this spirit that somehow finds its way in our churches, because you're nearing the end of the year and people feel like they're entitled to all of these other things. I want to let you know that God is watching you and everything that you're doing. And you do not have to do things the way other people do them. You'd rather say no like Daniel. You'd rather say no. He refused to defile himself. And you can see where God put him. Let every other person laugh at you because you're so boring. Let them laugh at you. Let them talk about you. Let them say whatever they want to say. But you're in God's good books, because there's a good book and there's a bad book. The good book is the book of life. And I'm praying my name is there, and I'm praying your name is there. But there is this other book of judgment on the other side. Don't lose your focus. Stay focused. There are these days that are coming ahead, but the Lord prepared this message for you. We have talked about four things that you really need to look at in the name of Jesus Christ. It's a long race. It is a long journey. Don't let anybody influence you. You have the Holy Spirit that is in you, but it will be very sad for you and for me to come back to church or on 31st, because I know 31st, most of us are going to be in our churches, because you want to cross over. It's good to start with God. And you are then kneeling down and telling God, I did this, I did this. No, don't do it. You just focus. Know that this thing of being lukewarm, it is there. And it only starts when you have not accepted who you really are. Because I believe anybody who knows who they really are will still keep the fire burning. That was the word that the Lord gave me. And I'm glad for it because I will also have to go through it and meditate on it and know that I'm also just as you. I'm a fellow servant like you are. So I also have to look at my ways and watch at where what I'm doing and where I'm going. But let us just be very keen on what you're doing in this coming month, the days that are ahead, in the name of Jesus Christ. I really thank the Lord for this one. I really thank the Holy Spirit for His word. He's very faithful. I want you to pray for yourself. I want you to pray for yourself. If there's that friend, and you know that friend, and you know this person is taking me nowhere, separate yourself early enough before you fall. There's something that the Lord is speaking to you about, and you know this thing is not right. I need to fix it. Do it now. This month of December should be a blessing. Intercessors, and you're all intercessors, we really need to pray. This is a time for us to pray and to pray and to pray. And the Lord is very faithful. He's going to speak to us because He loves us. We are His children. We are not like other people. In the name of Jesus Christ, preach the gospel to lost souls. Let them come back to Lord, to the Lord. It's not a time for us relaxing. There are people that God has placed before you. Talk to them, preach the word, and say, at least at this time when I was away, I preached the gospel. I prayed for the sick. Hallelujah. I encouraged people on the ground. I prayed for people that were demon-possessed, and they were delivered. That is what we are called to do. You don't need to fear anything or anybody. Fear the Lord. When you're clean and you speak that word, that person will be delivered. It is not you. It's the power that is in you. In the name of Jesus Christ. Because we are your fellow servant, your disciple. Hallelujah. And God said we will do greater than He did Jesus Christ. That is what He said. And you're supposed to do it now. Not going for other things, not looking for room to speak other things and wasting our times doing other things that don't matter. It is very easy for you to lose the glory of God. It takes only one small mistake. It is very easy for you to lose your position and your crown. It takes only one mistake. Don't lose your crown. Don't lose your focus. Focus on the Lord Jesus. Can you go before the Lord and start praying? Mababo Shandala Bosika. You've heard the word. You have heard the word. And depending on how the word has come in your spirit, pray for yourself. Pray for yourself. Pray for yourself. Maka masholo boze keteribo sikenda. Maka babo shandara bozi andara babo. Rima kosi kakatala babo jelelebo. Rakabazia katara babo shandara babo siya. I know that those who are going to listen to this word, O Lord. And it's going to minister to the hearts, O Lord. We refuse every other form of wickedness in the name of Jesus. Maka babo shandara boza. Reka makosi andara mando, shalara makosi ketaraba, rakaba boshikiri aganda, makosi kama koyande, shalara makosi yanda, shakalara mashanda, makarabozi keta, makanterika magosika, shantala baboria mazaya, shandala baganda. I'm praying for those who are going to watch this, O Lord. Protect them, O Lord, from the enemy. This is a seasonal one. This is the word that you gave me on this Wednesday. So that somebody cannot make the wrong decision. So that somebody cannot do something that is going to make you leave them, O Lord. Rakamashala bozanda rababo. Rakababo shakala rabazente. Rakabako zikala kanteri kababa. Shandaliri babosi kayanda ramando. Ye ke tererereba shalababozi antarabazakanda. They shall not die. They shall live to see the goodness of the Lord. Because it is you that gives life. Makataraba shata labosa. Rakamazika yanda labosika yanda. Shekerika mazoko mako yanda rabosika. Shakala rabosika yanda rabosia. Protect your children, O Lord. I declare healing for the sick. Rimabashika la mazayanda rabosika. You say in your word, by your stripes we are healed. Rima kontolo babo robo zanda laboza. Shakala rababo zeketeriaza. Ye kenteriya lababo shikayanda ramazaya. Makata rakata. Shakata lababo. Robabo sikanta rababa. She kenteriya lamazikayanda. Makashala mazianda ramazaya. For those who have evil spirits, O Lord, it is you that delivers them. It is you who can deliver them through your power. Mama babo rakata. Reke basoko toloba. Sheke reke makanterere wosika. In the name of Jesus. Mama bo shekende. Rima bo sika. Makata la mama. Rakamasia. Yekente rika babo. Makababo shanda. Rika makoyande. Yekete riria. Shalara babo. Ramba babo. Shikara babo. Yekezia na mama. Mashalara bo zanda la bo zeke tayara baganda. In the name of Jesus. You're there, you don't know the Lord. This is your opportunity. Because there are only two ways. You're either on the narrow road that is going to our Father, or you are on the wide road that is going to Satan and his demons. Let nobody lie to you. Let nobody lie to you. Rakabashanda la mazondo. Rakamazia la maganda. The grace of the Lord is here and it is now. Mashekete rimazoko lo mazoka yarababo shata. Makarabo shanda rabozia. Ye kente rika mazoka. Shakala rabozia la maganda. You're living a life of sin. Come back to Jesus. Come back to Jesus. Ribabo shekete, rababa shanda la bozayanda ramazika nda ramando, rababo shekaraba, la karakanda, shala rabozia, yeke rikamando, shikala rabaganda, yeke rereribo shala babo saya rabaganda. Oh my God. Rababo shanda la boza. Rakamako yanda ramasika yanda raboseke. Sheke ramakotia. Makatelika mikisikia. Ikiriki makoyanda ramazaya. Before we finish this service, I'm just going to lead somebody. You are there. You want to accept the Lord Jesus as your personal Savior. Just say, Lord Jesus, I come before you today as a sinner. I ask you to wash me with your blood, O my Lord. And forgive me of every other sin from the time that I was born. In the name of Jesus Christ. Forgive me of my sins. Cleanse me with your blood. Remove my name from the book of death. Write it in the book of life. Fill me with your Holy Spirit. Guide me with your Holy Spirit. I believe in you. I choose to believe in you. I believe in your word. And I want to walk with you from today. In the name of Jesus. I have believed in the name of Jesus in my heart that you are the Lord and you died on the cross for my sins. And I am ready to come to you. In Jesus' mighty name do I believe and pray. Amen. That is a sinner's prayer. Makarabo shalababo zanta labo sikende ribo shende. Rima mazia labo shekerie maziketa. God loves us so much. God loves us so much. And he has been here with us for 1 hour. And for those of you who are fortunate to join, The Lord bless you. The Lord do you good. The Lord keep you. The Lord fight for you because he has the power. Don't be afraid of anything. Just walk in the ways of the Lord. This is the Lord. He's going to reveal many things to you. Even at the time of his coming, the church is going to know. When Christ comes back for his church, we are going to know. And you are going to know because you are filled with the Holy Spirit. There are things that are going to change in the spiritual realm. And whatever the Lord wanted for you to hear, you have heard it in the name of Jesus Christ. So, thank you so much. This has been our time for the word. It's on Wednesday, Word Toast. And you've learned about the spirit of being lukewarm because it is a spirit, Jesus Christ. Thanks so much for being here. Thank you for being able to listen to the voice of the Holy Spirit. And I thank the Lord for using me. And I pray that you can share this because I know that so many believers are going to be transformed. I am blessed. I am honored. And the Lord has done it. If you're sick, the Lord has healed you. You're going through a difficult time. The Lord has not left you. He's still there with you. And he's the one who can deliver you from whatever it is that you're going through. So I love you so much. Sharing is caring. Share this message. Let it go all over the world in the name of Jesus Christ. And the Lord is going to do it because he is God in the name of Jesus Christ. And he loves us so much and he cares for us. So we are at the end of our online service on Facebook. I'm also going to share it on my YouTube channel, Revival Sister Betty. So if you've not had the opportunity to go there, you can go there and subscribe. And very soon I'm going to go live, probably very soon, because of the Lord and the doing of the Lord. So God bless you all so much for those who have been here. You can just click on those buttons and say amen from where you are. And the Lord bless you. I'm so glad. I'm so excited. I love you so much. God bless you all so much. It has been a powerful service. And I have been blessed. And I know you have also been blessed. But be on the lookout. Take care of yourself. I want to see you come next year. I want to see you having the glory of the Lord. I want to see you having been filled to the brim with the Lord's power, with the Lord's glory. Hallelujah. I thank you, Jesus. I thank you, Jesus. I thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. So see you so much.